Hello, everybody. Welcome to JUMP. JUMP stands for Jesus Uses Me Powerfully. Let's have some fun with our daily devotion. Today is March 23rd, 2020. Well, okay, it's time for our memory verses challenge. And you'll see it says verses challenge. On the next screen, I'll have a video for you. But I just wanted to let you see it first. Everybody take a look at these words. You'll see it for a few more seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's talk about this. Well, hello, it's time for our memory verse practice. And this time we have two verses. Since you have so much time and you're sitting around doing nothing but aggravating each other, let's look at Philippians chapter 2, verses 3 and 4. I know it's a lot of words, but you can do it. I know you can because I've seen you do it before. So get your Bibles. And by the way, I'm going to be getting one of my cool Bibles that you all have. I couldn't find it. I think Silas might have eaten it. No, he didn't eat it. I put it somewhere and I lost it. But look here. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 2, verses 3 and 4, do nothing out of selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility, consider others as more important than yourselves. Everyone should look out not only for his own interests, but also for the interests of others. Would you do something with me right now? Take your finger, and your fingers are little, so you can probably do this quick. Count the number of words in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. If I counted it right, there are 35 words there. And someone is thinking right now, that's too many. I can't memorize that. Yes, you can. Let's see. Do the math and divide it up whichever way you want to do it. If you did it six words at a time, it would just take you six times. That'd be 36 words. But just divide this up into small little portions that you can remember. Watch what I'm talking about. Do nothing out of selfish ambition. Do nothing out of selfish ambition. And just say it four or five times. Do nothing out of selfish ambition. What that means is, don't be doing this to get something out of it for yourself. And we'll talk about what the verses all mean. But what I'm saying to you is, even if you don't fully understand the words, learn them. Because after a while, after you've said them, after you've heard them for a while, you'll start understanding. So do nothing out of selfish ambition. And there, I just memorized it. And then what I'll do is tomorrow I'll add a couple more words and a couple more words. Your minds are so beautiful. They're young and they can remember things. See, I'm old. I don't remember things. So if I can do it, you can do it. So I want to encourage you, do nothing out of selfish ambition. And I didn't even look at my Bible just then because I memorized it. You can do it. I promise you. Try it. I want you to memorize Philippians 2. That's Philippians chapter 2, verses 3 and 4. And when we get back together after this virus has blown away or whatever it's going to do, we'll get back together and we'll have JUMP and you'll be saying this verse or these verses over and over and over again. And I promised you a reward and I'm working with Miss Cricket right now. And we're going to find something to make it worth your while. What I mean by that is you're going to be rewarded for your hard work. If you can memorize these verses, there will be something there for you. All right. I promise you that. I love you. Hey, get ready for your devotion. We're going to have something really cool. I have a new book I want to share with you. And just hold on. I'll be right back. Bye. Hello, I told you I'd be back. Hey, look, this is what we're going to be sharing together. Can you see this? This is a book I picked up a long time ago, and I was trying to use it in JUMP, and I just never had the time to sit down and read it. Well, guess what? I can't leave my house now, so I'm going to sit here and I'm going to read this book, and I'm trying to get my collar right. Silas jumped up on me and knocked my shirt all around, but look here. This is the book, and there's 100 questions in there, so we'll find something that'll be interesting to us. Here's what I want to read to you. It says here, can you see that? There you go. Q means question. A means answer. So I'm going to read the question, and then I'm going to share an answer, and we're going to get these books for you so you can study these along with me. But for right now, just let me read it to you, and then someday soon you'll be able to read it yourself because you'll have your own book in your hand. What is a Bible? What is a Bible? That's a good question. Well, let's answer this together. The Bible is God's message to us. Actually, the Bible is not just one book, remember I told you? But it's a collection of many books that have been put together. So who knows how many books are in the Bible? Come on. Come on. We just talked about this in JUMP. Remember the left side of the Bible? Let's see if I do this right because I have to do it backwards because you're looking at this. So if you're holding your Bible, you have the left side and you have the right side. That's if you're looking up at me and you have your Bible in your lap. The left side's called the Old Testament. The right side's called the New Testament. Okay, so the Bible is a collection of many books that have been put together. It came to be called the book because it's so important, because it's God's book. Did you know this? The word Bible, it actually means book. But we know now that it's actually a library containing many books inside it. So listen here, the Bible serves as an instruction manual for living God's way. I'm just reading this. It's the same thing you're going to be reading. It came to be called the book, and I already read that. I just went backwards. Oh, man. The Bible serves as an instruction manual for living God's way. It tells us what is right and what is wrong. It has many stories and lessons that He, God, wants us to know. The Bible tells us about God and about Jesus and how we're supposed to live. You can look in the Bible to find out what God wants you to do. Oh, this is so beautiful. And here's a verse that we say in JUMP. We actually sing it, and I can't wait to get my guitar out. Maybe I'll do that tomorrow if you all like this. I'll get a guitar out, and I'll play Thy Word. Will you turn with me in your Bibles to Psalm, that's in the middle, that's in the Old Testament. Turn to Psalm 119. As soon as you get there, I'll tell you what verse to go to. So I'm turning with you. Turn to Psalm 119. Okay, I'm going there. I'm trying to get there with you. Here we go. And look in verse 105. So look at the big 119. That's the chapter, or that's the number of the psalm. And then look for the little bitty 105. And when you find it, put your finger on it and read it with me. I'll give you a couple seconds to get there. I said a couple seconds, 1001, 1002. So that's it. That's all you get. The Bible says, your word is a lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Don't we sing that? Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. Remember we sing that? Okay, that's so cool. We go like this, Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. You can't see my feet, but I'm pointing down at my feet. And a light unto my path. You all thought it was just some goofy song I came up with. It came right out of the Bible. Isn't that cool? All right, well, maybe I'll try to find that song, and I'll put it in here tomorrow and maybe get the guitar, and maybe I can get Miss Cricket to film me, and Silas is sleeping because he was going to jump up on me if I grabbed my guitar because it's right next to his bed. Okay, would you do something with me right now? Would you please, and I'll take my hat off as a sign of respect, would you please pray with me right now? I know everybody's worried about this coronavirus, and it's all that's on the news. That's all everybody's talking about. I want to talk about God. I want to talk about Jesus. I want to talk about the Bible. I don't want to talk about some virus. Viruses come and go. And you know what? Y'all are going to see stuff as you get older, and you're going to wonder, wow, why was I so worried back then? Now, I'm not saying it's not serious. It is serious, but we need to love each other and trust God. All right, will you pray with me? Heavenly Father, stop. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Miss Wendy taught me something. Five fingers here, five fingers there. Put them together and say a prayer. Oh, that's so cool. I like it. Heavenly Father, thank you for letting us all get together. Thank you for the computers that are working right now and letting us talk to each other long distance, far away from each other. Heavenly Father, I ask you to keep people safe, keep people calm. Just let's work together and love on each other because we're going to be stuck in our houses together. And oh man, it's hard sometimes, but please just help us get along. And Lord, when it's your time, let this virus go away so we can come back to church together and give high fives and hugs and sing together in the same room. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I love you all. I'll see you again tomorrow. Well, actually, I'll talk to you because I can't see you, but I will try to be here tomorrow with another message and maybe the guitar and maybe a friend, because I had this guy right here and he's been bothering me to come in here. He wanted to talk to you all today, but he was sleeping with Silas. So we'll try to see if he'll talk to us tomorrow, okay? All right, bye-bye. Have a great night. Bye.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down, come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, mothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down, come on, mothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, fathers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down, come on, fathers, let's go down, down in the